got to win the game to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all, from working at all, from working at all.
Don't lay down and die because a new world order, the business of the day for the elite when you're coming to take your freedoms away.
Hello again, human beings from the planet Earth. We're here at my website, masterofmanythings.com, on another one of the activism pages that was put up in the last 24 hours or so, and I hadn't made you aware of it. Military activism, it's on the rise, it's definitely needed. Our military men are being abused, and different groups are forming to right the injustices of our military, one of which that the website sponsors is March Forward. Soldiers that are banding together to stop needing to go to Afghanistan to unnecessarily kill people. You can check out that both this link and the banner will give you some good information. Support that movement. And now this petition that I'll ask you to sign, which I already have done so myself, American Justice or FBI Cover-Up, an unexpected whistleblowing case on public corruption involving environmental crimes that lead directly to the collaborated and premeditated attempted murder of unarmed federal Veterans Affairs police officer in cold blood with federal agency knowledge, VA police service deliberate obstruction of justice, perjury, and willful complacency against an honorable federal police officer who was in clear and present danger, as well as his family. The link to the petition is here. There's some more details about that were included with the petition. And I want to highlight this email that I just received from the creator of this petition and the actual agent that is being affected. All of his contact details are on the military activism page, so you can reach out to Randy on your time and support him. On other levels, but I'll read this to you and then ask you to visit the website, sign the petition, and check out what's going on over there. Also, share that page with our military. If you are a member of a military-based organization that is doing what you can do to right the injustices of this illegal regime that is currently in control of this country, then please, it would be an honor to put your information on that activism webpage. And again, that is a free service. I'm not trying to get money out of anybody for the service. I want people awake, and I want all of our military being supported. That's the reason I put the page up. Anyway, to the email. I'll give you the shortest version possible because it is drug on for too long. From 90 to 2001, I was a federal park ranger for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Also trained FEMA Quality Assurance Inspector Disaster Relief. First went down to Puerto Rico with FEMA in 98. Hurricane George's lived in Puerto Rico all of 99 and returned to California for most of 2000. I blew the whistle on FEMA fraud, waste, and abuse with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Inspector General's Office in 99, but then was threatened with my life in September of 2000. FBI was informed in 2000. Too, but no investigation. So I up and left with my wife and kids back to Puerto Rico by March of 2001 after waiting for a diplomatic solution to my congressman failed. For the next decade, I lived in relative peace down in Puerto Rico. In 2008, I went back to work for the Veterans Affairs as a federal police officer in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Everything was going great. I even had a director's commendation from the Veterans Affairs. Excuse me, needed coffee. Anyway, but on October 19th, 2010, on my way home from work, I received a frantic phone call from my wife that men with machetes were threatening her and our daughter and destroying our home's only entrance illegally. The trucks doing the destruction belonged to a local government municipality. I telephoned my assistant chief of police and relayed what was happening, and she informed me to first stop by the local state police station for backup. A note, while off duty, I was always unarmed. I always turned back my service weapon each day after my shift was over and signed the log. I had the option to carry a personal firearm off duty, but because of the Puerto Rican bureaucracy, I never chose to do so, nor did I own any personal firearms. Upon my arrival, I had a digital camera and began to document everything that was going on while the state police officer investigated the scene. You can check out those photos there in the link that is also on the website. Earlier in September 27th, 2010, I had filed a civil lawsuit, but it was not on the dockets yet, as the illegal destruction of our water supply, but not the violence that had already begun in August 2010. On October 21st, 2010, my wife and I went to the Department of Justice and the FBI asking for their help because the threats were related not only to my race, but also to my profession by these men. It also became quickly evident, despite laws of Puerto Rico, that I indeed was a police officer assured certain protection for both my family and myself. The local state police only saw me as a gringo federal officer that could corruptly abuse by giving aid to men who were in fact acting as a criminal gang. After waiting for the federal intervention for what seemed like an eternity, as my family and I suffered nonstop attacks, sabotage, and threats, no federal relief came. It was just easier to blame the victims of violence and corruption rather than deal with it, or so I thought was their motive for leaving us to die. On November 24th, 2010, my assistant chief of police demanded I have a meeting with her. As my family and I were periodically being held prisoners in our home, I told her I would try. I was able to leave our home without indecent oddity enough, and in the meeting in San Juan's Veterans Affairs Hospital, we discussed the events in full detail with my assistant chief of police. One fact that came out was she was fully aware that I was not a federal cop. I would already be dead. If I was not a federal cop, I would already be dead. Then she hit me with the bombshell. She stated she knew I blew the whistle on USACE FEMA and quickly gave me an ultimatum. Return to your post a duty or face her wrath. Despite she full well knew and understood the danger to my family, our home, as well as myself, was in because of the lack of any federal intervention by the FBI or DOJ. In short, my post was more important than the lives of my family, plain and simple. How can anyone give a man a choice between his job or the lives of his family? I walked out saying nothing more. No, during my MSPB case, I discovered a document, Veteran Affairs memo, that directly connects federal nexus. My assistant chief of police, dated November 30th, 2010, 6 days after my meeting with her, with the actual men who first sabotaged my water system, then ambushed me when I attempted to repair it. In an attempt to murder me while unarmed with a machete and possibly one had a firearm on March 22nd, 2011, only a few days after I found out I had been terminated from the Veterans Affairs Police Service. All that time of holding out was waiting for federal FBI and DOJ intervention into the blatant corruption my family and I faced was not the worst that was to come. The VA memo is the key document that shows VA officials not only had a face-to-face meeting with these men, but actually condones by giving them aid in the premeditated attempted murder of a federal police officer. Both the DOJ and FBI are aware of this nexus and have done no investigation into this date that I'm aware of, because I still hold highly incriminating evidence under my control concerning Puerto Rico State Police corruption, municipal corruption, and local tribunal corruption involved in my case. I could write a book on this case, and I have lots more to share, but this is a quick rundown. In hindsight, it looks like someone very high up decided to allow me to be disposed of in payback for what happened between me, the USACE, and FEMA. The one I do have red-handed in this horrific case is my trusted assistant chief of police of the Veterans Affairs. I pretty much had figured out after the first week in October. The cavalry was not coming to our rescue despite the massive violations of both human and civil rights taking place, so I did the only thing I could to survive and document the hell out of it. Federal agencies involved or have knowledge of what happened to me and my family in Puerto Rico, USA, HUD, USACE, FBI, DOJ, VA, EPA, and many other U.S. government, federal police, and political offices, Puerto Rico State Police, the list goes on. I mean, this guy needs some support, and it sounds like that Randy has a lot more information. So that's the lowdown. I'm going to ask you to support Randy and come on over here to the website, sign the petition. There's some more information here for you, which when you click the sign the petition thing, you can get all of that, the petition letter, the petition updates, etc., etc. So that's the deal, folks. Military activism is up, and we need some help for Randy Dixon here and get this petition pushed so that he can have an investigation into what happened in his situation and the attacks on his family and his life. Anyway, there it is. Much love. Be safe.